In this video, I'm deploying a Windows Virtual Desktop host pool using a service principal. Hello, my name is Travis and this is Seraltos. In my last video, I walked through deploying a Windows Virtual Desktop host pool using a username as the owner. In this video, I'm going to deploy a host pool using a service principal instead of a user account to authenticate to Windows Virtual Desktop. But first, if you find these videos helpful, please take a second to subscribe. Also, click the bell icon to get notifications of new content. What is a service principal? To answer that, first understand that Azure AD separates authentication and authorization. Separating these functions makes it possible to use native Azure AD accounts, or an account synchronized from Windows AD, or even an external account like Gmail, all to access the same resources in Azure AD. An application in Azure should not be confused with what you may typically think of as an application. An Azure application object is the representation of an application registration in Azure AD. It provides authentication for the application. Just like users have objects in AD, so do applications that need access to Azure resources. An Azure Service Principal provides authorization. It defines the access policy for users and applications. Users and applications have service principals that define access. An application registration is a combination of Azure AD application objects and the service principal, providing both authentication and authorization. In this video, I set up a service principal by creating an application in Azure AD. This is a non-interactive account used with the Windows Virtual Desktop service. This way, the account is restricted to only the service it needs access to and won't use a fully privileged user ID. Let's cover the reasons why to use a service principal. First, user accounts should use MFA, especially any accounts with elevated privileges. But the account that authenticates to Windows Virtual Desktop services cannot use MFA. There's also a simpler reason not to use a user account. What if the user leaves? Windows Virtual Desktop is a PaaS offering. That means it's a multi-tenant service. This is the account used to authenticate the host pool to the Windows Virtual Desktop service. That could lead to all sorts of problems if the account is disabled or removed. A user account set up like a service account could be used, but that's more access than needed for Windows Virtual Desktop. Service principals provide only the access needed. To proceed, you will need a Windows Virtual Desktop tenant setup along with the RDS and Azure PowerShell modules installed. If you don't have that set, take a look at the video to get set up. The tasks in this demo are to set up the application registration in PowerShell, walk through the host pool deployment with the service principal, and lastly, test the connectivity. So with that, let's get started. Buckle up, everyone, it's demo time. So in this demo, we are going to create a service principal to use for Windows Virtual Desktop. There are actually two types of service principals, a password-based and a certificate-based. We're going to use the password-based. So the first thing I'm going to do is run these commands, and I'll make all these commands available probably on my blog. I'll put a link to it in YouTube as well. I'm not going to type these. For some reason, the more I type, the worse I get at it. I'm going to start by going over the modules needed. I already mentioned that we need the Microsoft RD Infra RD PowerShell module, and I set that up in my last video. But you also need the Azure AD module. Now, in my slide, I might have put that you needed the AZ or Azure RM. That doesn't hurt, but really what I think I meant was you need the Azure AD. And make sure it's an updated version. I was trying to do this with an outdated version and one of the commands wouldn't work. I'm just going to get the module to make sure we have them. Okay, so it seems like I'm missing a couple here, so let's just try to import them and see if they're available. Okay, it looks like on this computer I don't have the Azure AD module, so let me just install that quick. Here, all I'm doing is opening up a new PowerShell window running as administrator, and I'll install that module. That's finished. Let's go over and run this again. Now, if I do a git module, I should see those two modules, the RD PowerShell module and the Azure AD. There they are. Great. Now that all the prerequisites are met, I'm going to create an Azure AD context and assign it to a variable. And I'll just run this command. That's going to give me a login prompt. So I'm going to log in now, and I'm going to log in with an on Microsoft account, so a native cloud account. As I mentioned in one of my other videos, I normally use an external Gmail account to administer my subscription. But in this case, I need either an account replicated from Active Directory or a native cloud account. The next step is going to create the service principal. It's actually a command, a new Azure AD application. It's technically the Azure AD application registration of the service principal. I'm going to give it the name of Windows Virtual Desktop Service Principal. So I've got that highlighted, and I'll hit F8. You can also right click and code and do run selection. That command just created the service principal and application registration in Azure AD. Let's hop over and take a look at it. Here I am in Azure AD, and if I go to Application Registrations, and down at the bottom is my Windows Virtual Desktop Service Principal. So that has been created. Earlier I mentioned that there's two ways to create a service principal, either password-based or certificate-based, and that we're doing a password-based service principal. This is the step that will create that password. It's going to create the password and then assign it to the service principal creds variable. Next, I'm going to run three commands, and they're going to output some information. The first is the application ID. So this is my application ID for the service principal. The next one is the service principal creds value. So this is the actual password. So there's the password. And next is the tenant ID. So there it is. Those are the three pieces of information we need to deploy Windows Virtual Desktop with a service principal. But we're not done yet. We still need to assign the service principal rights into our Windows Virtual Desktop tenant. So the first thing I'm going to do is connect to the Windows Virtual Desktop tenant. Running that command will give me a login prompt. These login prompts are popping up behind Windows. It's kind of annoying, but I've gotten used to trying to find the blinking icon in the taskbar. I'm going to use the same native Azure account I used before to sign into RDS. And next, I'll just get my RDS tenant to make sure everything looks good. There it is. I'm going to assign the tenant name value to my tenant name. Next, we'll create the new role assignment, defining it as RDS owner for the application ID of the service principal we just set up and the tenant name we just logged into. That's it. We've assigned the correct permission. The next step isn't a requirement. This is just verifying that we can sign into Windows Remote Desktop with the service principal credentials we just set up. This step is going to create a PS credential object and assign it to a variable using the service principal that we just set up. And the next will log in with that account. From here, I can run commands against my Windows Virtual Desktop deployment. There it is. So that's working as expected. At this point, we've set up the service principal, and we've given it the permissions it needs to be able to deploy a host pool. So let's go over and deploy a host pool. And this is going to be just like before, only with a couple different names. I'm not sure why they're showing two here, but it doesn't seem to matter which one you select. I'm going to create. I'll start with my subscription. I'll leave that as pay-as-you-go. Next is resource group. I've got one that's already set up here. Host pool to RG. You could also create a new one if you needed to. I'm going to deploy this to Central US. I'm going to call this host pool 2. I'll leave it as pooled and add the user who's going to connect. Click next. I'm going to change it to light 15 and change that size down to something a little more economical and give it a prefix of, let's call it temp HP 2. Virtual machine settings. All this is pretty much what I did in my last video. I'm going to specify an account here that has rights to add these virtual machines into the domain. I will specify an OU and a domain. Under configure virtual networks, I'm going to select an existing network and a subnet. And remember that if you leave it as create new, this will not work. Next, I'll specify my tenant name. And here's the difference between my last video. I'm going to switch this to service principal. And if you remember earlier in this video, I said that there's three pieces of information you're going to need. This is where you need it. So let me just pull that up. So here we're going to need the app ID for the service principal, and that's the app ID property. So all I have to do is run this. That will give me the app ID. The next is a password, which is going to be the dot value property of the service principal credentials. And I just happen to have all these values, all these variables still loaded from the session earlier in the video. Last is the tenant ID GUID. There it is. So I'm going to copy this first one, and I'll hop back to the portal, paste that in. Then I'll copy the password. And the last is the tenant ID. That's all we need to set up the service principal. Let's review and create, and hopefully this will review okay. All right, validation passed. And I'll click create. I'll pause here while this creates and come back in a minute. I'm back and the host pool has been provisioned. So this is host pool 2. Let's see if I can log in. I'm just gonna open up an incognito window and I'll go to the web client. That's rdweb.wvd.microsoft.com/webclient. And here I'm gonna sign in as the user who I set up with access. Here we are. The user has access to two host pools. Host pool 1 is the host pool I set up in the previous video. Host pool 2 is the one I set up just now. I'll allow access. I'll sign in. Finally, here I am at the desktop. That's it for the demo. In this demo, I set up the service principal, gave it the role assignments for a Windows Virtual Desktop, and then deployed a host pool with the service principal. That's it for the demo. I hope you found this useful in understanding what a service principal is and how to use it with Windows Virtual Desktop. If you enjoy these videos, please don't forget to hit subscribe and click the bell icon to get notifications of new content. Thanks for watching.